Well, hello, you awesome people. How the heck are you? That is a fire that I had going yesterday. It was about 5:30 in the evening. I got off of work, started a fire. I didn't put the fire out. I let it burn all night, and actually all day today. So that's a 12-hour-old campfire. I don't know if you can call it a campfire. I wasn't camping, but it's been outside my house for 12 hours. Smoldering. And I try to see if I can rekindle the old flame. Not that way, but not what you're thinking about. Not a relationship, a fire. I used the top of an old ice chest, styrofoam ice chest. And as you can see, it's still hot. It's still burning. That's why you should put out your fires at night. Because a bit of wind comes along, it gets nasty. So you put some kindling on there, and I put the little piece of wood on there, piece of paper so it wouldn't blow away. And it kind of did blow away, but that's okay. It doesn't matter. It's a fail, but it's a win at the same time, because I got the campfire going, even though it wasn't a campfire. I'm ready to go camping again, if you can't tell. But you put some more oxygen on it, because fire loves oxygen. We'll take the wood off of there, and you'll have a, you know, it's smoldering, and there it goes. Bye-bye. Off to burn somebody's house up. Hopefully not. And it's really hot now. Now it's really hot, and so we'll put the little slivers of wood back on them coals, because we want some far. Remember, kids, it's not fire, it's far. And we'll fan them flames a little bit more. Keep on burning, because we're going to get some far. So, you know, when you're camping or whatever, and if you're new to camping or, you know, to the outdoors, if you wake up in the morning and you say, oh my God, my campfire's out. No, it's not really out. If you don't douse it and with like a ton of water, your campfire is never out. It will burn for a long time. So we'll put a couple of pieces of wood on there. Evening wood. And fan the flames a little bit more. And it's going to pop up in a little bit. There we go. And instead of moving my GoPro away from the fire, I'm just going to try to center the shot and not worry about my GoPro burning up and being incinerated. I'm a super genius. I can make a fire and destroy a GoPro. And GoPro lived. So did I. But that thing will, that little fire will just, it'll pick up in a second. I'll go ahead and fan the flames more. Fan those flames. And the more oxygen you put on it, the bigger the flame's gonna get. There he goes. And it's just enjoyable getting outside by a fire at nighttime. Whether I'm at my house or, camping out. Good deal, but that's how you start a campfire after you think your campfire is dead, because it ain't dead. Put a little wind on it, put a little wood on it, and you'll get her done. I'm just saying. Boom, there we go. Maybe Jeff will move his GoPro away from the fire. There Jeff goes. Good Jeff. Remember, kids, when you build a campfire and your GoPro is next to it, be like Jeff and move the camera away.